Let me hear you say. In Bed-Stuy, a lot of people had reputations for different things. Deirdre Garfield was 23 and had a reputation for being the youngest grandmother in Brooklyn. Mr. Jackson had a reputation for being crazy as hell, and a lot of people say he invented homelessness. I had a reputation too, not only for being a nerd or getting beat up every day, I was also known for being the best asteroid player in Bed-Stuy. People from all over. Chinatown, Rikers, the Village. Even though I was a nerd, it felt really good that there was one thing that nobody could beat me at.
Chris, somebody beat your score last night.
Hey, even Mike Tyson got knocked out. Ain't this about a... had paying bills down to a science, but there were always things she didn't count on.
Oh, damn it.
Hey, honey.
Hey, baby.
What's wrong?
Well, I used this month's phone bill to pay half of last month's electric bill, and now I don't have enough for the gas bill.
Well, why don't you just use the electric bill money to pay the electric bill?
Well, Tanya had to get a filling. She had a cavity.
She did?
My father never knew when there was anything wrong with the kids, unless we were unconscious or in the hospital.
Oh, no. We're gonna have to cut back.
Cut back on what? I mean, we're barely getting by as it is.
That look only meant one thing.
No. Uh-uh. Not my turtles. You are not taking away my turtles.
My mother loved chocolate turtles more than anything else in the world. Whenever she ate one, it was like all of life's problems just went away. It's a good thing she chose those turtles instead of guns.
Those chocolate turtles are costing us $12 a box.
Oh, you gotta take away my turtles. You know I need my turtles. Why don't you cut off your lottery plan?
I'm not cutting on my numbers. If you don't play, how can you expect to win? Look, it says so right here.
No, not that damn dream book.
My dad was the most level-headed person I knew, except when it came to playing the lottery, and he always consulted his Lucky Star dream book. A dream book takes any possible dream you can have and transforms it into a lucky number.
You dreamt about a monkey on a train in the middle of a blizzard.
Here it is, 814.
I dreamt Dr. J was roller skating with two white women in Sweden.
Here it is, 621. White ladies? Rochelle, if I win the lottery, you can buy all the chocolate turtles you want. But you eating chocolate turtles ain't helping nobody.
Well, if you play the lottery, I'm eating my turtles.
Fine. I'll quit the lottery.
Okay, then.
Can you believe this is a real argument? At school, even Greg was getting a reputation.
And for best attendance, Greg Bulliger.
Yes!
Getting an award for attendance is kind of like getting an award for breathing.
Wait, your dad is giving me $5 just for coming to school.
I bet him I wouldn't miss a day of school this year. So far, so good.
My mother told me I better not miss a day of school or else she'd take $5 off my ass.
This is so cool.
The only award I could have gotten at Corleone would have been...
for taking the best ass whooping, Chris.
gun!
But instead of an award, I had asteroids.
Hey, I got the top 5 scores on asteroids yesterday.
Get out of here, no way.
Yeah, but some kid beat me. I have to protect my title.
Man, you're just like Apollo Creed and Rocky too. You sure you can beat this guy?
Hey, I've got a reputation to maintain.
Hey, Tanya, ask Daddy for some money so we can get some candy tomorrow.
How come you can't ask?
Because if I ask, he'll give me a speech. If you ask, he'll give you the money.
If Daddy gives me the money, you have to share some of that candy with me.
Okay.
Dad. Huh? What?
Can I have a dollar?
What you need a dollar for?
I want to get you some candy.
Oh, that's nice.
My father was crazy about Tanya. She was the only one in the house who would dare take sleep and money from him at the same time.
Thanks, Daddy.
In Bed-Stuy, we never had a real video arcade to go to. All we had was Doc's. At Doc's, you can get almost anything. You could cash a check.
That'll be $5.
You could get an alibi.
Nah, it wasn't him. He was here. That'll be $5.
You could even get your teeth pulled.
Open. Your mama know you down here?
Yes, sir.
My mother didn't like me hanging out at Doc's because she thought that would eventually lead to this.
I'm a junkie. A crackhead. Look, Flipper, just tell mama her oldest son is a crackhead.
Hey, little dude from across the street.
Usually Jerome would rob me, but not when I was about to play Asteroids.
You getting ready to play Asteroids?
Yeah, some kid beat my score.
For real? Oh, no. I know you're not gonna take that, man. You better protect your rep.
If I didn't get my high score back, somebody was gonna get hit with a brick.
Come on, take care. Give me.
You're Chris.
Hey, he's big.
So you're Doa. Doa.
And that's D-O-A. It means dead on arrival. My name is Jorge. So what, you want to play? Come on.
I know it looks strange, but before people got PlayStations in their back seats, you actually had to go someplace to play video games.
That was a good game. Hey, hold up. Where you going?
I gotta get home.
What, you're not gonna give him a rematch?
Yeah, you can't just beat the man and walk out.
Hey, I really gotta go. Besides, I just beat him again.
Ooh. Wanna put some money on that?
If you have a good reputation, you have to be willing to do anything to protect it.
I can't play for money.
Oh, don't tell me you scared.
I'm not. I just gotta go home.
Man, I can't believe you scared of this dude. Come on, go, get, come on, go.
Anybody got $5? Everybody hates
Chris. Hey, I need a favor. I need to borrow your $5.
What? What do you need it for?
I beat this kid playing Asteroids, and now he wants to play for money.
Can't you just save up your lunch money? Or take a neighbor's garbage out? Or help small ladies carry groceries to their car? Or return some Coke bottles or something?
Note to self, when begging, be persistent.
Hey, I don't have time for this. You gotta do this, or my reputation's gonna be ruined.
I wonder if that's how OJ got AC to drive that Bronco.
Thanks.
After a day with no turtles, my mother was going through serious sugar withdrawal. She'd eat any sugar she could find. From anywhere she could find it. All I can tell you is that crack ain't got nothing on chocolate turtle.
Here.
Drew was getting his fix, too.
I know you give me more than that.
You're not supposed to be eating candy anyway. You just got a feeling.
I'm telling Mama.
Some people had wine, my mom had Aunt Jemima.
Mama, Drew got some candy and this is all he gave me. Three peaks.
Candy? Did you say candy?
Yeah.
Drew, get in here! You got candy?
Mom.
Don't mind me. Don't mind me right now, boy. Do you have anything in here that tastes like turtle?
No.
Something has chocolate, peanuts, caramel, something like that?
I don't know.
Well, where in the world did you get money for candy?
Daddy. Oh, you
see what? Now that's what I'm talking about.
What he's actually talking about is which one of us he's gonna rob after we get through with the game.
How? Whoa, what's wrong with you?
Turtles. I ain't got my turtles. I'm over here drinking syrup while you're still buying lottery tickets. What's wrong with me? What's wrong with you?
Baby, I did it for you.
Julius, we both had an agreement. And you have to honor that agreement. Do you know what kind of message we are sending to our children?
Message?
You're telling our kids, oh, go ahead, little children. Ignore your mother, because she's a lunatic.
I didn't say that.
Yes, you did.
What I meant was, it's just a couple dollars.
Are we cutting back? Or am I cutting back? Because I can't do it by myself.
No, baby.
I feel alone.
No, no, we cutting back. We cutting back, okay? I'm sorry. We can do this. We can do this.
I get the shakes at night, Julius. I get the shakes.
All right, we can do this.
Okay.
Good game. You almost had him.
You got a lot of heart, little dude.
I wonder if I could sell my heart for $5.
You lost? How can you lose?
Hey, I'll pay you back. I'll carry some groceries or return some soda bottles or something.
That crap will take forever.
Well, why'd you tell me to do it?
Because I didn't want to give you my money.
I'm as surprised as you are.
No, I'd say you're about $5 less surprised than I am.
He's starting to sound like my father.
Hey, I'm gonna pay you back. It'll take a couple of weeks, but I will.
You gotta play him again.
No, I don't think so.
What about your rep?
I've got a new one. Sucker. Come on.
I miss being the asteroid champ of Bed-Stuy. Without that, I was just another bum from the neighborhood. My father wouldn't usually admit he was wrong about things, at least not in front of the kids.
I have something to say.
I thought he was about to tell us he was leaving us for a white family across town.
I'm sorry.
What'd you do?
After your mother gave up her chocolate turtle so we could pay the bills, I played the lottery. I shouldn't have done that. I was wrong.
Is that why she ate up all our candy?
I should have never given you money for candy.
Dad, it's not all her fault. I asked her to do it, but only because I knew you'd give it to her.
How'd you know that?
Because you give her everything she wants.
That's not true. One time I asked if I could set Chris on fire and he ain't let me do that.
Well, thank goodness for that.
I have a confession too. I've been hanging out at that corner store.
Chris.
But I was only playing asteroids.
Huh. Well, that ain't so bad.
And I lost $5.
What? $5?
Ooh, I'm telling.
Now, who you gonna tell? We're all sitting right here.
How did you lose $5, boy?
Where did you get $5?
I bet a guy playing asteroids. And I got the $5 from Greg.
What are you doing betting on video games?
I was trying to protect my reputation.
You have a reputation?
Yeah. I am the best player on the block.
Ooh.
Then how come you didn't win?
Because you need to be quiet, that's why. You're always yelling. You ain't talking about nothing. Shut up, shut up.
That's enough. That's your problem. You bought it, you pay it back.
I am.
Well, I know I better not hear no more about you betting money. You hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Mama, can we have our candy back?
No. I ate it. I don't need y'all getting any more cavities than what y'all got. No cavities in this house.
But at this rate, there'll be plenty of diabetes.
I need some more sugar.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm just tired. I had this weird dream last night and couldn't fall back to sleep.
Dream, huh?
Yeah, it was bizarre. I was walking down the street, waving hello to everybody, but nobody was waving back. It was as if they couldn't see me.
So you were invisible?
Yeah.
Mama had turtles, Daddy had the lottery. It's a wonder nobody sold the TV.
I need you to go to the corner store after school and buy a lottery ticket for me. 637.
Yeah, but you said you weren't going
to... I know what I said. I just got a feeling about this.
Translation, just shut up and do what I tell you.
Now keep this between me and you, all right? 637, all right? And keep the ticket on you. Go, 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 go.
He hadn't been that excited about a dream since Martin Luther King's.
What do you need today?
My father played the lottery 1,000 times and lost 1,000 times. I had only lost my rep once, and I wasn't about to let that happen again.
Give me 4 quarters.
Now you're talking.
You wanna play me for some more money?
I don't have any money. I just wanna prove I can beat you.
Man. Should have bet me, though.
If I had bet him, I couldn't help but think that this would have happened.
Right. It's good, huh?
I'm hungry. Who are you?
I'm Jorge. I warned your family from Chris playing asteroids.
I told Chris to stay out of that store.
Can you cook my fungo?
What?
What you call her?
Comer tu comida. I was raised around Puerto Ricans.
There's something about defending your reputation that makes you feel like you really accomplished something. And even though I didn't get Greg's money back, I had my rep. Even though my father never won the lottery, it always made him feel like there was one thing in the world he had a shot at winning. And to him, that dollar was worth it.
And tonight's winning numbers are 6, 3, 7.
I won! I won! I won!
What happened?
My number hit! Chris, show your mama the ticket! Show your mama the ticket, man! Show your mama the ticket!
Mama!
Bring your ass up to the stage. I'm gonna knock your head off, I swear to God. Summer night is gonna be mean. Let it happen. Have a good time. Unattractive people are very needy. Always want something.
Excuse me. Excuse me. You know where I can... No, I don't. No.
Right foot, what it is? Hey, you already know.
Get by that!
Go! Greatest of all time.
In my house, everyone had a job. It was my father's job to pay the bills.
I'm cold. I'm hungry and cold.
Eat a piece of cracker. Your father's coming.
I got the money.
It was my mother's job to keep the house and the kids in line.
Boy, quit leaving your socks all over the place. Boy, mop the floor. Girl, clean up the table.
Good job, baby.
As kids, we only had one job. Go to school and get decent grades.
Bye, Mommy.
Love you.
Love you.
Have a good day. Don't come home stupid.
We won't.
I could usually get a good grade just by talking about Dr. Martin Luther King. In English class.
My book report is on Dr. Martin Luther King.
In history.
My history report is on the Birmingham bus boycott led by Dr. Martin Luther King.
The only place Martin Luther King didn't work was in math.
Chris, what's the square root of 144?
1963? The same year that Dr. Martin Luther King led the March on Washington?
No, it's 12. All right, class. Pick up your report cards on the way out and bring them back signed tomorrow.
Oh, no.
What?
I got an F.
Oh, man, that's rough. What's your mom gonna say?
I don't know, but it ain't gonna be free at last.
A B+ in gym. Good job. You can have whatever you want for dinner.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Thanks, Mom. Can I have pork chops and spaghetti?
You sure can.
Yeah.
Well, Mom, I got a B in science. What do I get?
You can have whatever dessert you want.
Ice cream and cake.
Ice cream and cake it is. Good job, baby. Oh, boy. Don't you see me cooking?
Sorry.
Where's your report card?
They didn't hand them out yet.
I couldn't bring myself to tell my mother I got an F. Next to dealing drugs, getting bad grades was the worst thing you could do. It was worse than this.
Tanya, what happened?
Mama, I had to smoke that food.
Oh, not him. I'm talking about this D you got in algebra.
And worse than this.
Joe, where is that food? What the hell is wrong with you?
I'm following my dream, Mama. I'm gonna be a country and western singer.
I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about this F. Now take your Johnny Cashless ass upstairs and study. You think I'm playing with you? And where you get that guitar from? You better not be selling no damn drugs in my house.
I didn't know what to do, but I couldn't give her that report card.
Well, let me know when you get it.
Yes, ma'am. Need any help cooking?
Sure.
Thank you, baby.
I figured if I showed her how useful I could be, she wouldn't kill me when she found out. While I was trying to figure out what to do about my F, my father was homesick trying to figure out how he got the gout.
Oh, baby, when did you get the gout?
I don't know. It just happened.
I know you're probably wondering, what is the gout?
Well, gout, or the gout, as some people like to call it, is a form of arthritis, which causes severe swelling, usually in the ankle or the big toe. It's caused by a poor diet, including things like smothered pork chops.
You need some salt.
smothered chicken fried bacon.
Need some salt.
And smothered chicken fried bananas. Not bad.
Need salt.
Are you out your damn mind?
All right, I'm going to work the phones over at the real estate office today. Try not to eat any junk. I'll be home in time to make dinner.
I can't eat that stuff all day.
You can if you want to get rid of the gout. Let me kiss.
When are you going to turn your report card?
I was thinking, it's so busy that if I didn't say anything, Miss Marola would just forget about it.
It didn't take much to graduate from my old school. All you needed was a ride to the graduation.
Who are you?
It's in Miss Jenkins' class.
Oh, here.
Thank you. Chris, where's your report card?
My mom's been really busy. I promise I'll have it by tomorrow.
Make sure you do.
Because my father was used to working all the time, staying home was tough. But at least he got to watch one of his favorite things, soap operas. The Yankees were good, but not better than soap operas. At Corleone, if you needed something like a forged report card or a tardy slip, there was one guy that could get it for you, and his name was Fisher.
Hey, Fisher.
What's this?
Chris.
Tell him I'm not talking to him.
He's not talking to you. Chris.
Your friend he was?
Yeah.
Pat him down.
He's clean.
What does he want?
I need a new report.
Hey. Tell him I'm not talking to him.
He's not talking to you. He needs a new report card. He got an F, but he doesn't want to show it to his mother.
Okay, I got it. It's a two-part job. He needs a report card with an A for his mother to sign, and a report card with an F with his mother's signature on it.
So you'll do it?
I'm not talking to him.
He's not talking to you. So you'll do it?
Okay, let's say I do this for him. What's he gonna do for me?
What do you want?
How about a book report for English? Hey, what the hell's the matter with you? Don't you see me talking to you?
Don't you see him talking to you?
Can it be a Martin Luther King?
Deal. Meet me in the science lab storage room at 3.
Thanks.
Yeah. Hey, look over there.
Hey, Julius.
Rochelle's not here.
No. Rochelle told me to stop by and check on you. And I bought you this.
What, a salad?
Yeah, a salad. I gotta get back. The Young and the Restless is off.
I never had a forged report card before, but Greg told me Fisher was the best. He made such a good fake, they arrested the guy who made the original.
Hey, Ma, I got my report card.
Oh, let me see.
I was scared. Felt like I was giving a fake diamond to Little Kim.
An A in math? Chris, that's so great.
You got an A in math?
That's right. So what?
What's 3 times 3?
9.
What's 4 times 5?
20.
What's 11 times 11?
What do you think?
Shut up. Can you sign this?
What do you think? Oh, he does?
Julius!
Oh, hey. Yeah. Oh, I gotta go. All right. I'll talk to you later. Oh, man!
Who was that?
Oh, that's Monica. Sheila's hairdresser's friend. She just wanted to know what happened.
Well, you two were on the phone an awfully long time. Did you know that your son got an A in math?
My man. That must be why his teacher called this afternoon. You know, she wants you to come down to the school on Wednesday and talk about Chris's grade.
Will Rochelle find out about Chris's actual grade? How long will Chris be able to keep up this lie? Will Julius ever get rid of the gout? Will Tanya ask Chris more math questions? Will Drew get any lines? Find out this and more when Everybody Hates Chris returns.
Everybody hates Chris.
Once I got my mother's signature on my report card, Fisher had what he needed to complete my plan.
What? I'm a natural. Now beat it.
Since I had the cards in place, all I had to do was keep my mother and Mrs. Morello from seeing each other, and I would be home free.
Chris, do you have your signed report card?
Sure do. My mother says she won't be able to come to the school tomorrow. My father has the gout.
Did you say the gout?
Yes, the gout.
I'm concerned about your grade, Chris.
My mom is too. She told me I better get a C on my next report card. And then she... Well, let's just say it's kind of hard to sit down.
So I guess she's young and he's restless.
Okay, hey. We're gonna come back tomorrow for the update, okay?
Hey, wait. So does Victor's ex-wife know about him and Nikki?
We'll find that out.
Hey, babe! Hey, how you doing?
What's going on? Why didn't you tell us Julius likes the young and the restless?
I didn't know.
This is Pam. You remember Pam.
Yeah, girl.
How long y'all been here?
Oh, about 3-4 hours. You know, we're just catching up on the soaps.
Okay.
Oh, this is my girl, Monica. Monica, that's Rochelle.
Nice to meet you, Monica.
Why do you look so familiar to me?
You tried to sell me food stamps down by the subway that day. I thought you said you weren't selling food stamps.
You were selling food stamps. I wasn't selling no food stamps. Just go get the phone. You hear the phone ringing? It rang like 3 times already. Thank you, baby. Girl, that gout is making him lose his mind.
Listen.
Mess with your hearing.
Hello? Hey, Mrs. Morello. Yeah. Hold on. Honey, it's for you. Where'd they go?
They left, gout boy.
Hi, how are you?
What? An F?
What happened?
The teacher just told me that Chris got an F.
But he said he got an A.
I can't believe that boy looked me dead in the eye and lied to me.
How you want to handle this?
Translation, do you want to kill him or should I?
Oh, I know what to do.
Whoa,
pancakes? Hey, Mom, we're having pancakes?
No, Chris is having pancakes. That's my baby's reward for getting an A.
Can I have some pancakes?
Did you get an A?
I got a B.
That's not an A.
Can I have some pancakes? I think my foot's getting better. I might be able to make it to work tomorrow.
Pancakes are for people who get A's, not for people who get the gout. Baby, you want anything else? My A student deserves nothing but the best.
No. Oh, by the way, my teacher says she won't be able to see you today.
That's okay, baby. I'll talk to her next time. You want some butter?
My foot's looking better, don't you think?
Why are you talking about your foot? Your son has no conscience. And they're eating pancakes like he actually got an A.
If you didn't want him to have the pancakes, what you give them to him for?
For him to feel guilty and confess. That's okay. Tomorrow I got something for him.
Baby, let's talk about this. Come on.
Oh, so now you want to talk to me? Why don't you just talk to your friends, since you talk to them all the time?
Rochelle, those are your friends. We were just talking about the soaps. Are you jealous?
Hell yeah, damn Skippy. How would you feel if you came home and I was sitting there talking to a bunch of your friends about football?
You like football?
No, I don't like football. Julius, you always want to talk to me about the Bills or the kids. I just think it would be nice to talk about something else for a change.
You want to talk about the gout?
No, I don't want to talk about the gout.
So we're
Yep, I told my mother that Miss Morello was busy, and I told Miss Morello that my mother was busy. That was that, and I'm just glad it's over.
They say when you're about to die, your life flashes right before your eyes. Well, here's what mine looked like.
Definitely not in there. Bye, Chris. Don't tell when you guys when you get to heaven.
Hey, Chris, can I have your comic books?
That's a $2 pair of underwear you messing up.
Rest in peace, Toby.
Chris?
Hi, Mom.
I don't mind me. I'm just here to watch my brilliant mathematician son in action. Miss Morello said it would be okay.
If I could just be cool, maybe everything will be all right.
Today we're doing fractions. What does 3/12 plus 3/4 equal?
Oh, me, pick me.
Rochelle.
Chris has an answer. He got an A.
That's right. He did get an A.
If I could drive, I'd do this.
I don't know the answer.
No? Well, how is that possible? You're the math whiz. The human calculator. You got an A.
I actually got an F.
This must be how Mary and Barry felt when that tape got out.
Miss Morello, thank you for your time. Come on, Chris.
See you later, Slimy. Ma, I can't explain.
Okay. Go ahead.
For real?
Yeah. Explain this.
Okay. I was afraid you'd get mad at me for getting an F. I thought I could do better next semester. So I changed my grade, forged your signature onto the report card, and gave it to Miss Morello. I thought you wouldn't find out.
I thought you wouldn't find out. Boy, what do I look like, Boo Boo the Fool? You running around here lying, forging my signature? Have you lost your mind? Look, Chris, if you lie, you steal. If you steal, you kill. And I am not getting your behind out of jail. Chris, if you would have put this much effort into passing the class in the first place, you wouldn't be in this mess. I am very upset that you failed that class, but I'm more upset that you lied to me. You are not stupid, Chris. Don't act like it. And remember, I brought you in this world. I take you right out. Do you understand me?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. I'll bring you behind on.
My mother had a funny way of making me feel like the smartest idiot in the world.
Wait, that's it?
No. You better bring that grade up or I'm gonna slap the wax out your ears.
After I got caught, my parents finally had something to talk about.
What happened with Chris today?
Well, I got it all handled. How's your foot?
It's all right.
Got a surprise for you. I watched your soap today.
Really?
Yeah, but if you don't feel like talking, we don't.
No. We can talk about it.
Well, did you know that Nikki was a stripper?
A stripper?
Mm-hmm.
Is Victor now?
He does now.
Things always worked out best in my house when everybody did their job. And after being more embarrassed than I'd ever been in my life, all I had to do was one more thing.
Mom, I got my report card.
A D! My baby got a D!
And you're happy about that?
I'm just happy I don't have to smack the chap off your lips.
Everybody hates Chris!
Why don't you go ahead and put us in the room? Today, we're talking about the notorious B.I.G.
These are the isolated vocals from Blue Monday.
Britney Spears.
Metallica.
Prince.
Nirvana.
People want to dance. People want that groove.
Wow. I love it.
When Big Frida says, release the wiggle, that thing is going everywhere. It's an earthquake going to be careful.
You're going to hear the song completely differently after you listen to the episode.
I was just thinking that.
Chris, how many times do I have to tell you to quit leaving this damn yo-yo on the floor? What are you trying to do, kill me?
I forgot where I left it.
Well, will you remember when I fall down the steps and break my neck?
Sometimes it felt like all my mother did was yell at everybody.
Tanya, close the door. You trying to freeze the whole house? Drew, turn that mess down. You trying to make everybody in the house go deaf? Hey, get your feet off my table. Julius, pick up your drawers. Do I have to do everything around here?
And when I say my mother yelled at everybody, I mean everybody.
Rochelle, what did I tell me? Are you trying to drive me crazy?
But there was one person who always put my mother in a good mood.
Daddy!
My mother loved her daddy, and we did too.
Oh, where's Mama?
Oh, I left her at the hairdresser. Where them grandkids of mine? Where they at? Hey! Daddy, go on!
My grandfather was a great storyteller.
He didn't think I was playing when I smacked him in the head with that brick. Right now. And until this day, when I go in there, my food's as free. Right.
Oh, man, do you have any more good jokes?
Do I got any more good jokes? Come on now. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Pass me them pork chops.
Pass me them pork chops, too.
No, pass me them pork chops right there. Come on,
man. Oh,
God. I ain't playing with you, son.
What's the rest of the joke, Grandpa?
Okay, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Oh, Lordy.
Oh, Lordy.
I'm dying.
I'm dying who?
I'm having a heart.
You're having a hard who?
Daddy. Daddy. Daddy?
I never did find out who was there. My grandfather passing away was the first time I had to deal with a death in the family. I didn't know how to react, and I guess my mother didn't either, because instead of doing this...
Damn! Damn! Damn!
She did this.
Good morning, everybody.
I hadn't seen my mother that happy since Lionel Richie went solo.
Can't believe Gene is gone.
I can't believe he never finished that joke.
I'm never eating pork chops again.
I can't believe he died sitting right here.
Huh? Everybody has to die someplace. Now, eat your eggs.
I hate eggs. Can I have some toast?
Sure, Tanya. No problem.
Hey, Mom, do I have to go to school today?
Usually, the only death that could keep us out of school was our own.
No, not if you don't want to.
Cool.
Chris, do you want to stay home from school today?
No, I have a quiz.
Oh.
Can I stay home, too?
Sure.
I didn't know what was wrong with my mother, but at that moment, all I could think of doing was this.
Snap out of it, woman!
Well, everybody have a nice day.
That was weird.
Man, your grandfather died? That's rough. I had a parakeet that died once. I cried for 3 weeks.
My mom is acting really strange.
You mean strange like...
There's a TV in my head! Ow! Please, just make it stop!
Even the crackheads would be scared of that.
No. She's just really nice.
So, were you guys close?
Yeah.
Chris, why don't you stand up and tell the rest of the class what you're discussing with Gregory?
My grandfather died.
Chris, that's not funny. What are you going to do when your grandfather dies for real? Just because you didn't study for a test doesn't mean you can go killing off your family. Who's next? Your father? Your mother? Why don't you kill your sister or your brother?
He's telling the truth.
Oh. Oh, Chris.
Wait. You believe him?
Of course.
And not me.
Well, Chris, your grandfather died. You might say anything. What are you even doing here? Bring me your paper. Don't worry about the test. You're excused.
In honor of my grandfather, I should have hit her with a brick.
Hi, Mama. You look good.
Oh. And that's my grandmother, Maxine. She was the only woman who could outsnob my mother.
Your hair smells funny. Are you still using that cheap perm? Dark and lovely? Mm-hmm. Look at mine, it's beautiful. It's beautiful, isn't it? Good to see you too, Mama.
Oh. That's my Aunt Charlotte, but we called her Greeby because we only saw her at funerals. No birthdays, no weddings, just funerals.
Girl, I haven't seen you since Cheryl's funeral. I know.
Greeby, stop crying. Come on.
Okay.
Okay, let me go. Come on.
That's Aunt Mousy. We called her that because she talked like a mouse, and she only spoke when spoken directly to.
Hi, Aunt Mousy. How you doing? Huh?
My Uncle Michael was almost 40 and never had a job. He put the in bum.
Hey, sis, how you doing?
Oh, good.
Y'all got something to eat?
Yeah, we just...
I think he saw a job chasing me.
Hey, Shaft. That's too bad about your grandpa. Sorry.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, he's going to teach you how to tap dance now.
Later that day, he beat up a Chinese kid in my honor.
Everybody,
good to see you. So I'm gonna take Michael and Charlotte upstairs to get situated. Are you okay, Mousy?
Okay. Come on upstairs, follow me. Julius, shouldn't you be at work already?
Hey, you know I'm on my way. Oh. I just came by to say hi real quick. How are you?
Well, as can be expected. You know, Jean and I were married for 40 years.
I hope Rochelle and me make it that far.
The way she keeps this house, I'm surprised you haven't left already.
My grandmother always criticized everything my mother did.
Mama, you like my coat? It's all leather.
Oh, feels rubbery. Feel mine. Italian leather.
At home, even though my mother seemed to be keeping it together, the house was falling apart.
Michelle, can you change the channel?
Sure, no problem.
They were treating her like she was me.
Rochelle, you gonna help me pick out this casket, or do I have to do it by myself?
Oh, sure, Mama. I'll help you in a minute.
Oh, Shelly, give me a glass of iced tea.
Sure, Mama.
Oh. Damn it!
What?
You ever had the feeling you were about to get smacked upside the head with a yo-yo?
Here, baby. Be more careful.
You're not mad?
Oh, why would I be mad? Here, Mama.
Mmm. Oh, this tea tastes funny. What kind is it?
I think it's Lipton.
Mm-mm. Tastes like Nest tea.
It's Lipton.
Ugh. Hey.
Hey. Want a turtle?
My mother offered me a turtle? In her world, that's a cry for help.
No thanks. You okay, Ma?
I'm fine. You sure you don't want a turtle?
What was that for?
Just want to let you know that I love you.
Since my father was working extra hours and my mother wasn't being herself, I decided to pick up the slack the best way I knew how.
Tanya, you go make up your bed. Ju, you clean up in here. I'm sitting here playing cards.
This was gonna be harder than I thought.
Turn that mess down. You trying to make everyone in the house deaf? Take your feet off the table.
Rochelle, tomorrow we're going to the funeral home to pick out a casket. Please dress presentably. I don't want them to think that we can't afford a decent casket.
Sure, Mom.
You okay, baby? You need to sit down?
Oh, no, I'm fine.
As bad as she felt, I didn't know it was about to get worse.
Rochelle, can't you make a decent glass of iced tea?
Well, can't you leave her alone? It's iced tea. If you're thirsty, well, then you'll drink it. If you're not, don't.
I might be joining my grandfather sooner than I thought.
Are you gonna sit there and let that boy talk to me like that? Why don't you know I'd knock you into another family?
Who are you?
You don't want to know. Everybody hates Chris.
Hey, man.
Hey.
Chris, you know you're gonna have to apologize to your grandmother.
How come? She's the one who's been mean to Mom.
She's hurting, Chris. And your mother is, too. I know you're trying to protect your mother. But trust me, you do not want to get between the two of them. You ain't gonna win that one. You're already going to one funeral. Ain't trying to go to another.
Well, then, what do I do?
Do what I do. Nothing. Things will work out, right? Apologize.
You can't really believe you're getting married until you buy that tux. And you can't really believe somebody is dead until you gotta buy them a casket.
Now, we have several models. This one right over here, top of the line. Made of mahogany, huh? Has silk lining over goose down bedding. And a nightlight.
I guess that's in case the dead want to read.
Well, Mama, what about the blue one?
Oh, now the blue one is nice.
Oh, I don't like
that. She don't like that one.
It's a coffin, not an Oldsmobile. I like that one.
Good taste.
Maxine, that costs a lot of money.
Now we got payment plans.
Well, can we put it in my father-in-law's name?
Well, no.
I didn't think so.
Okay, Mama, whatever you want.
Rochelle, even if we split this five ways, that's still a lot of money.
Who's talking about splitting it?
Well, I just assume we'd all chip in. I mean, it is your husband.
Judas, I want to help out.
What's this?
It's a baseball card. Al Oliver. He played in Pittsburgh. Lifetime 330 hitter. That card is going to be worth thousands of dollars someday.
How much is it worth now?
About a dollar.
I got $40 saved up. What about you, Aunt Mossy?
Some too bad he won't be playing asteroids.
Mama, I just don't think that we can afford this right now. Why not? Baby, you always bragging about how your husband has two jobs. I do not.
I do not need this. My man has two jobs. My husband has two jobs. I don't need to be here right now. I do not need this. My man has two jobs, okay?
My husband deserves to be buried with dignity. Now, who are you to deny me that?
Well,
Mama, we're not trying to deny you that.
That's right. How dare you? You only died once. You let him go and stop.
Fine! You do whatever the hell you want. Mama, come on!
Mama, I wasn't trying.
I'm coming, Mama.
Shell, you wrong.
Poor baby.
We'll take the blue one. My daddy liked blue.
I always hated that picture. It made me look like I got smacked in the head with a brick.
Oh, hi, Daddy. You want a turtle?
No, but how are you doing?
I'm okay. Mama's getting on my last nerve.
Oh, she can do that. She used to get on my nerves, too. You know, just because I'm dead doesn't mean you have to let her push you around. And if she tries to do that, you smack her in the head with that brick.
By the day of the funeral, there was still one thing left to fight over. Who gets to ride in a limo?
Doing in here?
Hi, I'm Monet. This is Aisha and this is Kiki. We saw the limo, so we had to hop in it.
Where y'all about to go?
A funeral.
Oh, I'm sorry. Who died?
My husband.
Okay, well, when y'all get back, and if y'all not taking the limo, can we take it to the club?
Okay.
The only thing more crowded than a limo before the funeral is your house after the funeral.
Hey, what are you doing here?
My dad dropped me off to pay my respects.
Thanks, man.
He had to go to work.
Mama, come look. Chris got a white friend.
Michael, close your mouth. Stop acting like you never seen a white person before. Hi, honey. You hungry? You want something to eat?
Sure.
Well, come on.
Mama.
No, thank you.
How about a sinky? It's like a slinky, but it don't go anywhere.
I left a whole load of sloppers in the kitchen for you guys.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Chris, I got a new video game at the store.
Look.
Next time someone dies, let me know. I get you a good deal on the casket.
What is your problem? Hey.
Sorry about your grandfather, Chris.
The one good thing about losing a family member is that you get lots of sympathy.
What are you doing?
My grandfather died.
Just because your grandfather died doesn't mean you can go around hugging people. Sorry about your grandfather.
At least somebody was getting some sympathy.
Who is that?
I don't know.
A little dude from across the street. Here you go, man.
What's this?
I robbed your grandfather a few times. I didn't know you knew him.
Wait, my turtles. Oh, is that what you call them things? I ate them, but they was nasty. What's in those things anyway?
If you didn't like them, why did you eat them? Mama, I am sick of you. Ever since you got here, you have not stopped complaining. Just because Daddy is dead does not mean that you could come into my house and tell everybody what to do. And Michael, get your feet off my damn couch before I slap the jam out of your toes. And Grievy, stop all that crying. You cried on Easter, you cried on Halloween, you cried on Flag Day. Get some Kleenex, wipe your nose, cause it ain't that damn sad. And hang up my phone. And Aunt Mousy, take off your coat and speak up. You're over there peeping and squeaking. You sound like a damn rat. Use your words. You're damn near 60 years old. And Mama, the next time you want to eat my turtles, the least you could do is like them.
She's back!
Hey.
Hey, baby.
How you doing?
I'm fine.
I brought you your turtles.
Hey, turtles. Thank you.
I'm proud of you for standing up to your mother. You had me worried there for a minute.
Why?
I thought you were about to smack her with a brick.
So good seeing you, girl.
Yes, yes.
You take care. You owe me some Kleenex.
Oh, okay. See, lettuce, sis. Thanks for all the chicken in here.
All right, stay out of them pretzels. Bye. So, did he say anything before he died?
Who, Daddy?
No, Martin Luther King. Yes, your father. Did he mention me?
No, he just asked for more pork chops.
I know what you're thinking. She should have lied. But actually, the truth was better.
Figures. I like the flowers.
You like them?
I guess so.
I know that doesn't seem like much of an apology after everything that's happened, but here's what she really meant to say.
Baby, I am so proud of you.
I know.
Oh, you are doing a wonderful job.
I know.
I wish my no-good son would stand up for me the way your son stood up for you.
I know.
And your father? Oh, he would be so proud of you.
I know.
Well, Mama, why are you so damn mean?
I don't know.
Oh, and baby, your hair, it don't stink.
I know.
See you around.
Good.
Take care, Ma.
That's all of it.
Oh, thank you, baby.
I'm really gonna miss him, Mom.
Me too, Chris. Me too.
Chris! Get in here and pick!
y'all. My father died, for goodness sake, and now you trying to kill me too.
Everybody hates
Chris. Bring your ass up to the stage. I'm gonna knock your head off, I swear to God. Unattractive people are very needy.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
Even though I was the oldest, I never felt like Drew's big brother.
I'll take him.
People expect a big brother to be better at everything. Dominique Wilkins was a human highlight film. And Gerald Wilkins watched a lot of film. Bill Clinton was the president of the United States. But Roger Clinton needed a presidential pardon. But with me and Drew, it seemed like no matter what we did, he always came out on top.
I'll take Drew.
He was better at sports. He was better with girls.
Hi, Drew. Hi, Drew.
Hi, Chris.
She's kind of cute. He looked older.
Two for Scarface.
You can go, but your little brother's gonna have to see something else.
But I'm older than him.
You wanna see a movie or don't you?
I actually went to see Mr. Mom that day. It was pretty good. But worst of all, he was a better big brother than me.
I'm gonna get my big brother on you. Chris, go get Drew.
When they heard Drew's name, they ran.
And you were standing right there?
Just like I'm standing right here. Gotta do something. I get the crap kicked out of me here. Leave my little sister knows I can't fight. That's why I'm gonna ask my mom if I can take karate.
Why don't you take boxing lessons?
Nah, if you tell people you can box, then everyone wants to fight.
How come nobody messes with your brother?
Because he knows karate. And if they mess with him, they think he might kill him.
That's perfect. If you learn karate, you'll never have to fight.
All right, Tanya, hold your ear.
I imagine this is how it must be before they hit the switch.
Ow, you burned my finger!
Well, if you be still, that wouldn't happen.
Why can't I just go to the beauty shop like you?
You got beauty shop money?
No.
All right, then, be still. Your daddy barely wants to pay to get my hair done. I know he's not gonna spend an extra $10 to get yours done, especially when I can do it here at home.
Hey, what's burning?
My hair.
Tanya, stop fidgeting so much. You're moving like a squirrel. Sit still.
Mom, can I sign up for karate lessons?
Why don't you just learn from Drew?
Why don't you just mind your own business?
You need to
shut up
and
let your hair
get cut.
Okay? Chris, go ask your daddy. I can't be bothered with this right now. Tanya, bend down so I can get the kitchen. Girl, I didn't even touch you.
Hey, man. What's going on?
Dad, can I sign up for karate class?
Karate class? Why don't you just learn from Drew?
I want to learn from a real teacher. Drew just does stuff he sees in movies.
Everything Drew knew about karate, he got from the masters of Channel 9 Asian Invasion, Grandmaster Lung T, and the immortal David Chung.
What are you going to do with karate anyway?
Just in case someone messes with Drew and Tanya, I want to be able to do something.
My father knew I couldn't fight, but he never said anything about it.
How much is it gonna cost?
It's free.
Oh, all right, go ahead.
For free, my father would let me learn almost anything.
What are you doing?
Taking how to knock off a liquor store lessons.
How much does it cost?
It's free.
Go ahead.
Do four, now!
Don't hurt anybody.
If I didn't want to hurt anybody, I wouldn't be taking karate.
Baby, you should have listened to me. I told you to keep still.
Hey, I'm headed to work.
All right, baby.
Baby, what happened?
Mama burned me with the hot comb again.
Oh, let Daddy see. Ooh, Michelle, that looks bad.
Ah, she'll live. I don't think it'll make a scar.
Yeah, but that's 18 cent worth of butter she's holding on her forehead. What, you can't do her hair without burning her?
I told you before that I wanted to take her to the beauty shop, and you told me no.
My father thought that going to the beauty shop meant that Tanya was growing up too fast, and she would end up like this.
She's 10 years old. Why I gotta spend money getting her hair done?
She's tender-headed, she moves around too much, and she keeps getting burned. And I'm sick of this. So either you pay to get it done, or you do it.
If my father didn't want to do something, my mother got to decide how it would get done.
Why are you cooking biscuits and ribs for breakfast?
You gonna do it?
Go ahead. Why are you cleaning a tub with a broom?
Are you gonna do it?
Go ahead. How much is it gonna cost?
$10.
Mm-mm. Nope.
Daddy, please?
That never worked for me.
Okay.
I am Mr. Jackson, your sensei. Shotokan karate is a very ancient art of combat. Karate literally means empty hands. Now, what we're gonna do here today is learning how to whip somebody's ass with your empty hands. Mate. Mate.
So, are we gonna be learning how to break boards?
You got some against boards? Huh? What has a board ever done to you? Has a board ever embarrassed you in front of your woman? Asked Yolanda for a phone number and dared you to do something about it? And did you just stand there and watch her get into the board's car and just drive off?
No.
That's why we ain't learning how to break no damn boards. Now I want each and every one of you to listen to me and watch. It's called the Shaolin Handbreaker. Now this move guaranteed to break anybody's hand. But I don't want y'all to try this. It's very dangerous. Come here, boy.
Me?
You.
If you want us to do this, well, then why are you showing us?
Because that's what martial arts is all about. Learning ways to kill people, and they're not doing it. Now grab my shoulder.
At that moment, I learned two things. One, I learned a great karate move, and two, this fool was crazy.
Man, karate? Sounds complicated. I tried wrestling once, but I got knocked out. Wait, you got knocked out in the wrestling match? I'm as surprised as you are. Well, I'm doing good. My sensei says I have a lot of potential. I think I might even be better at this than Drew. Wouldn't you have to kill him to find that out? I never thought of that.
Mama, how long do we have to wait?
Hush, girl. My appointment was at 3:30. It's only 5 o'clock.
The only thing you wait for longer than a washer at the laundromat is a chair at the beauty shop.
I'm ready for you, Rochelle.
About time.
Watch your mouth, girl.
Hey, Vanessa.
Hey, Rochelle.
Oh, okay. Pam. Ooh,
yes.
Can I make an appointment for Tanya?
Yeah, I can squeeze in this week.
Oh. Girl, don't tell me that's your daughter.
Sure is. Isn't she beautiful?
Yeah, she's big, huh?
Ooh, she sure is. Pretty soon she'll be old enough to date Richard.
Mm-mm. Ooh, do not tell me his old ass is still chasing after young girls.
Girl, I thought you knew.
He the only one's dumb enough not to run when they see him coming. He old, he broke, he need a fool.
There's one thing that you get at the beauty shop that you don't have to pay for, good gossip.
And I heard Peggy, she said that she caught them in her house.
Wait, in her house?
Yes.
What, did she stab him?
Girl.
Because you know I would have stabbed him.
Oh, I knew you would have stabbed him, but she just...
Now he's staying with Lisa.
Light-skinned Lisa?
Bow-legged Lisa.
Mm. Wait a minute. I thought Lisa was with Darius.
She was until Darius caught her with his brother.
The one with no job.
Yeah, him. And he married, too. A wife, a girlfriend, and no job. You know these men, they just ain't no good.
They're no good.
Get out of here.
You know what you do. Oh, I throw the hot grits.
Tanya never listened to my mother until she heard something she wasn't supposed to.
you doing?
Working on my form.
Why do you take lessons anyway? I saw some stuff in The Return of the Five Deadly Venoms. It was way cooler than that.
Yeah, right.
I bet you can't hit me.
Now, I think I can.
Then try to hit me.
But I don't want to hurt you.
No, I dare you. Try to hit me.
All right, then. Fine.
I was just getting warmed up. Was an accident. After breaking Drew's hand, I felt horrible.
I'm gone for 10 minutes and y'all breaking bones. I knew that karate class wasn't a good idea.
Rochelle, it was an accident. Just boys being boys.
Do you even know what they're teaching Chris down there? Where were you when this happened?
Sleep.
Mm.
What's that supposed to mean?
Mm, means she's gonna blame him for the rest of his life.
Sleep again, huh? That's how Chris broke Drew's hand.
Rochelle, that was 45 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Well, don't worry about it. I'll deal with it. I'll go down there tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Ouch!
It still hurts?
Of course it hurts. It's broke. Chris, help your brother with his Kool-Aid.
Daddy, do you have a girlfriend?
What?
Well?
No! Why would you ask me a question like that, baby?
Because men ain't no good.
Where'd you hear that?
At the beauty shop.
And where were you when they were talking like this?
Relax, it's just girls being girls.
I am not paying good money so my baby can get her hair done and come back hating men.
She does not hate men.
What am I supposed to think when she come home talking like this?
Fine, I promise I'll talk to the girls at the shop and make sure that they don't gossip around her.
Mm-hmm.
Even with a broken hand, Drew still managed to come out on top. If I had known you could get this much attention with a cast, I would have let him break my hand. Mr. Jackson was an ex-Marine who taught karate when he was on his medication. When he was off his medication, he did this.
Yolanda! Yolanda!
Jackson! ¿Cuántas veces te voy a decir que me dejes en paz, okay? Así que vete para allá y no me jodes más.
Yolanda!
Can I help you?
Yeah, my son Chris was taking your class here.
Chris? No, I don't really Chris. Was there, is there a problem?
It's just that the boys were fighting and Chris accidentally broke his brother's hand. He says you taught him.
Hmm. Who was fighting?
Chris and my other son, Drew.
No, I don't know any Drew. Either way, I ain't had nothing to do with that.
No, man. I ain't say you had nothing to do with it. I'm just saying that...
Come on, baby. Let's go.
Hey, baby.
Get the piano.
Let me get with that phone number.
She repeated all that to Julia.
I didn't even know she was listening. She barely listens to a word I say.
Rochelle, I am so sorry.
Me too. From now on, we watch what we say in front of her.
Let me go pay half down on our light bill before they close. She'll be okay, though, right?
Girl, go ahead. She'll be fine.
Mm, we watch Little Miss Nosy for you.
Okay, Taya. I'm gonna leave for a little while. I'll be right back, okay?
Okay.
All right. Be good. Y'all make her beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
So is Richard still cheating?
Is the Pope still Catholic?
Vanessa.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's a reflex. Tanya, I don't think that we should be talking about Richard.
Why not?
because that's grown folks' business.
Oh, is that why my mom and dad got an argument?
An argument?
About what?
Well, asked my daddy if he had a girlfriend, and he said why, and then my mom said, well, do you? And then he asked me why I asked him that, and then...
Although my mother told the girls not to gossip to Tanya, she didn't say anything about Tanya gossiping to them. At that moment, I was having more trouble coping with Drew's broken hand than he was.
Drew, if you need a nurse, I'll be happy to come over and get... You better not let Mama see that.
Drew still has that cast, and he hasn't finished calling all those girls yet.
Hey, you need any help with anything? I could tie a shoe.
Nah, I got it. I can tie it with one hand.
Okay, I could write out your homework.
No, I'm fine. I never wrote with my left hand before, but it turns out I'm really good at it. Want to see something else I could do?
I always thought I needed two hands to do this.
I had to face facts. Drew could do more with one arm than I could do with five.
You wanna sit on my back?
Your hair looks nice, baby.
Thank you.
So what you and the girls talk about?
You and Daddy.
What? What about me and Daddy?
Told everybody about the argument.
Tanya, you just can't go around telling our business.
Why not? Everybody else does it.
Well, that's different.
How?
Well,
my father was worried about Tanya learning the wrong things, so my mother taught her a few things herself.
Tanya, you're a big girl now, okay? And you gotta know that there is no difference between what they said to you and what you said to them. It's still gossip. But you gotta remember two things. You talk about other people, not yourself. And number two, what you say in the shop stays in the shop. Got it?
So, don't tell Daddy.
Right.
Hey, Mama.
Uh-huh?
Wanna hear about what happened to Carla?
What happened to Carla?
Hey, what happened to you?
I had an accident. What are you doing?
I thought Drew's arm would get itchy under the cast, so I'm making him a hand scratcher out of a hanger.
Listen, you're gonna have to be more careful. You're gonna be doing karate. I know it was just an accident, but you could have really hurt Drew.
Dad, it wasn't an accident.
What?
I hate that you can do everything better than me. Tanya even calls on him when she gets in trouble. We were fighting. I tried the handbreaker on him, and I fell.
Chris, being brothers ain't easy, all right? I have six brothers, and whether you like it or not, somebody's gonna be better than you at something. But you can't be jealous. He's the only brother you got. Besides, I don't know if you realize it, but he looks up to you.
He does?
I didn't realize that no matter how cool your little brother is, he still wants to be like his big brother. It worked out for Keenan and Damon Wayans. Not so great for Eric and Lyle Menendez.
You need to apologize to your brother, Chris. That's my boy.
Hey, Chris, watch this. I love this cast.
Cool, but I have something to tell you.
What?
I tried to break your arm on purpose.
How come?
Because I'm tired of you being better than me at everything.
What are you talking about? I bet you're better than me at some stuff.
Like what?
I don't know.
Uh-huh.
But you're still my big brother.
Yeah, but you're bigger than I am.
Yeah, but every time Mom and Dad leave the house, they always put you in charge. I wish I could be in charge.
That's just a lot of work.
So? Plus, you get to go to school all the way in Brooklyn Beach. I wish I could ride the bus to school every day.
You do?
Yeah. That's so cool. Everybody in my class is always asking me what it's like at your school. You're the coolest big brother out of all my friends.
It never occurred to me that even though Drew was bigger and cooler and better with girls,
the coolest thing to him was that he had me.
Hey, Chris, can you show me that move?
I'll try. It might not work because I've had training. It's basically you take your opponent's hand.
I think I got it.